congregation, please stand. Love comes from God. Everyone who truly loves is a child of God. Let us come and worship Almighty God. Dear friends, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Laura Jean Getz and Andrew J. Smith, to surround them with their prayers and to share in their joy. The scriptures teach us that the bond and covenant of marriage is a gift of God, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh, an image of the union of Christ and the Church. As Laura and Andrew give themselves to each other today, we remember that at Cana in Galilee, our Savior Jesus Christ made the wedding feast a sign of God's reign of love. Let us enter now into this celebration confident that through the Holy Spirit, Christ is present with us now. We pray that Laura and Andrew may fulfill God's purpose for the whole of their lives. Congregation, would you be seated? Let us pray together as we confess our faith, and you will see it come up on the screen. Let us pray. Gracious God, always faithful in your love for us, we rejoice in your presence. You create love. You unite us in one new family. You offer your word and lead us in life. You open our loving arms and embrace us with strength. May the presence of Christ fill our hearts.
1 Corinthians, the way of love. If I speak with human eloquence and angelic ecstasy but do not love, I'm nothing but the creaking of a rusty gate. If I speak God's word with power, revealing all the mysteries and making everything plain as day, and I have faith that says to a mountain, jump, and it jumps, but I do not love, I am nothing. If I give everything I own to the poor, and even go to the stake to be burned as a martyr, but I don't love, I've gotten nowhere. So no matter what I say, what I believe, and what I do, I'm bankrupt without love. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than for self. Love doesn't want what it does not have. Love doesn't strut, doesn't have a swelled head, doesn't force itself on others, isn't always me first, doesn't fly off the handle, doesn't keep score of the sins of others, doesn't revel when others grovel, takes pleasure in following truth, puts up with anything, trusts God always, always looks for the best, never looks back, but keeps going to the end. Love never dies. Inspired speech will be over someday. Praying in tongues will end. Understanding will reach its limit. We know only a portion of the truth, and what we say about God is always incomplete. But when the complete arrives, our incompletes will be canceled. When I was an infant at my mother's breast, I gurgled and cooed like an infant. When I grew up, I left those infant ways for good. We don't yet see things clearly. We're squinting in a fog, tearing through a mist. But it won't be long before the weather clears and the sun shines bright. We'll see it all then, see it as clearly as God sees us, knowing him directly just as he knows us. But for right now, until that completeness, we have three things to do to lead us toward the consummation. Trust steadily in God. Hope unswervingly. Love extravagantly. And the best of this is
reading from the book of Ephesians. For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. I pray that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through the Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus, to all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Song of Solomon. The voice of my beloved. Look, he comes leaping upon the mountains, bounding over the hills. My beloved is like a gazelle or a young stag. Look, there he stands behind our wall, gazing in at the windows, looking through the lattice. My beloved speaks and says to me, arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. O my dove, in the clefts of the rock, in the covert of the cliff, let me see your face, let me hear your voice. Your voice is sweet, your face is lovely.
Okay, take a deep breath and preach.
Love never gives up. We speak a lot of words concerning love. Books have been written, poems have been penned, and professionals have appeared on talk shows and talk radio concerning this theme we call love. Yet as I read and as I listen, I hear very little about the fact that love never gives up. How can that be? Love never gives up. What gets missed in the discussion about love is this. We forget to discuss that the author and the creator of this thing we call love is who? What gets left out and overlooked is the one who gave us this gift of love. Oh, we talk about the full of emotions and the tears running down our eyes. We talk about the plucking of the heartstrings. We talk about the far-reaching aspects of love, yet we don't talk about what is very near and dear to us. The gift giver of love. And that this giver gives this gift in the sense that it never gives us. Now, Laura and Andrew, I don't want to lay a guilt trip on you. I don't want to place in your path a stumbling block when Scripture tells us that love never gives up. I simply want you to know and trust in the fact that God will never give up on you. You might give up on God. You might get down the road and there might be days you might be thinking about giving up on each other. You might think about giving up on yourself. But if you can remember that God never gives up on you, you never have to get that far down. I think if more people talked about the fact and understood this, then those rough places in life would be places of learning. Places where you learn to trust God even deeper. Places you know that, hey, I'm not in control of the dominance. I'm kind of out of control. I'm losing it. But you know, God will never give up on us. Why should we give up on God? The second thing I want you to remember, Scripture says love cares more for others than it does for self. That's a hard one to remember, because in our society, we care very little for each other. We can only see ourselves. I know this is a hard teaching, that love cares more for others than for self, but let me give you an example. Say, for instance, I want you to think back before Andy popped the question. Say, for instance, before that time, I know I've seen the tape, before Andy popped the question. Think back before that, and you didn't understand that love cares more for others than self. As you maybe were leading up to the point where a question could have been popped, wouldn't you have thought to yourself, hey, I'm a pretty girl, or I'm a handsome guy. Why isn't he or she asking the obvious question of me? Because after all, look at me, I'm special. After all, greatest gift since sliced bread and one size fits all. Love cares more for others than yourself. Keep that in mind. You have your first argument, love cares more for others than for self. It's not about winning, it's about loving each other. And the last thing I want you to remember and to do is to trust God always. God is the author of life, God is the creator of love, God is the gift giver of love. Trust God always. I only lifted up three things. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than self. Trust God always. Three things because it will remind you that in the covenant of marriage, there are three partners. Remember this through the wedding session? There's you and you and God. And when there's a fight, it's two against one. And the best fight of all is when the two of you fight against God because they both will. Your arms are too short to box with the Lord. It's never about Andrew. It's never about Laura. If it is, it's just about God. It's always about the two of you because God loves you that much. The two of you plus God makes three. And you live for an eternity. God's love. Thanks be to God. Have a deep Let us stand now and confess our faith, the faith we've been baptized, confessing our faith together. We believe in God, who has created and is created, who has come in the true man, Jesus, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by his Spirit. We trust him. He calls us to be his church, to celebrate his presence, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus, crucified and risen, our judge and our Lord. In life, in death, and in life beyond death, God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God.
Please be seated.
I said last night, this is the last chance you have to run, and it's a clear shot. Before God and this congregation, I ask you to affirm your willingness to enter into this covenant of marriage and to share all the joys and sorrows of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. Andrew, will you have Laura to be your wife, and will you love her faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God. And Laura, will you have Andrew to be your husband? And will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
And folks, they cannot do this by themselves. They need your support as family and friends. You need to be there for them and point them always towards the direction of God, because we can't control them, but God can. And so, do you as the people of God pledge your support and encouragement to the covenant? Covenantal commitment that Laura and Andrew are now making together, so answer, we do.
We do.
Thank you.
proud of their mothers and of their fathers. Hear our pledges encouraging and supporting this union of Laura and Andrew. Bless us as we offer our prayerful and loving support to their marriage. Bless them as they pledge their lives to each other. With faith in you and in each other, may this couple always bear witness to the reality of the love to which we witness this day. May their love continue to grow and may it be a true reflection of your love to us all. Through Jesus Christ. Laura and Andrew, speak your covenant promises that you have come to offer before God this day. Laura, we see that. Andrew, I give myself to you. To be your wife. I promise to love and sustain you. In the covenant of marriage. From this day forward. In sickness and in health. In plenty and in want. In joy and in sorrow, as long as we both shall live. And you can be after me. Laura, I give myself to you.
Laura, I give myself to you.
To be your husband.
To be your husband.
I promise to love and sustain you.
I promise to love and sustain you.
In the covenant of marriage. From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness
and in health. In plenty and in want.
In plenty.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
As long as we both shall live. And Andrew, Laura, what will you share to symbolize your love? By these symbols of covenant promise, gracious God, remind Laura and Andrew of your encircling love and your unending faith that in all their life together they may know joy and peace in one another. Laura, I give you this ring.
Laura, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
Laura, respond by saying, I receive this ring. As a sign of our love and faithfulness. Repeat after me. Laura, Andrew, I give you this ring. As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and
faithfulness. Andrew, respond, I receive this ring.
I receive this ring.
As a sign of our love.
As a sign of our love.
Those whom God had joined together, let no one separate. Laura and Andrew, you are wife and husband with the blessings of Christ Church. Be merciful in all your ways, kind in heart and humble in mind. Accept life and be most patient and tolerant with one another. Forgive as freely as God has forgiven you, and above everything else, be truly loving. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, remembering that as members of one body you are called to live in harmony, and never forget to be thankful for what God has done for you here today. The grace of Christ attend you, the love of God surround you, the Holy Spirit keep you, that you may grow in holy love, find delight in each other always, and remain faithful until life's end.
Thank you. Christ, with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, reigns in love forever and ever. Amen. And now, Almighty God, we ask that you would hear the prayer that Jesus has taught us to pray together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Would the congregation please stand for the benediction? May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May God look upon you with kindness and give you his peace. And go this day knowing that you go in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Following the announcement of the couple, the family invites you to Fellowship Hall for some food and fellowship. And just hang a left and go straight. I present to you Andrew and Laura Smith, husband and wife. Thanks be to God, and you may clap.
Ha ha ha. so here we go. But I wrote a little something here for Andy. It was a little something like this. Andy? Sorry, we're just waiting for the music. Can everybody hear me? Okay, everybody get your dinner? Everybody's eating? Enjoying it? Feel good? All right. So, I wrote a little something for Andy here. And it was a little something like this. Andy, you mean so much to me. You've always been there. I have a nice car, and I have to pee. Just kidding. Just kidding. Anyways. But seriously, Andy has always been there for me. He's always been one step ahead of me, too. We first really, really got to know each other in band. We've been playing the trumpet for years with Mr. Salamone, all through elementary school, middle school, high school. But he was always just a little bit better than me. He's getting first at state, and then I try to say he's the same, and next year I get the second or something. But he's a fine trumpet player, and we'd always be fighting in academics too. We'd always just be trying to compete and see if we could get the best grades in our physics class or our bridge building competition. And also, in speech class, we had a debate. And it was over creationism and evolutionism. And to this day, I really don't think any of us know who won. But I think I came out second. I won. There you have it. So I was second in speech class, so I apologize if this speech sucks. And now here he is today, beat me to marriage. It's a beautiful woman, and I'm sure they'll have an excellent life the rest of their lives together. But in all seriousness, because Andy is so blessed and gifted by God and just has all these amazing attributes, he's given me some real encouragement over the years, and I'm sure he has for all his fellow classmates. All the people that come in front to Piggly Wiggly every day, just get to see a smiling face in the checkout line. And he's a really blessed and special person, and Laura should feel extremely lucky that she gets to spend the rest of her life with such a great man. Yeah. And on top of that, in my life, Andy has brought me up mountains with him. We've climbed mountains together. We've spent so much time together in our childhood, but I'm sure at one point our parents didn't even know whose kids were whose, because we'd go over for a night and then we'd have fun the next day, and then I'd call my mom and say, Mom, can I spend the next night here too? And I think one time we spent 3 days at a time just at each other's houses, just having a good time. And he's just been such a great friend to me. I've been thinking a lot about God's path, how it's brought Andy and Laura together, Andy and me together, and all the good things that have come into both of our lives because of the way God works through us. And I'm sure he has thousands of blessings for you guys, for your future, and I'm sure that you guys together will be such a bigger blessing to this world than you can imagine. So, Andy, thanks for being such a great friend. Congratulations, Andy and Laura. And I wish you guys much luck in the rest of your lives.
You're here.
Around his neck, but I think I made some
giving breaths to his physical well-being.
Yes, he did.
Thankfully, I didn't have to see any of those through, because his eyes have been wonderful to Laura. And it's about time he's been welcomed into our family as an official member, rather than an honorary member. And maybe now that they're married, they can move on from the kids' table and sit with the rest of the adults. And it's pretty obvious seeing you two together that you make each other really happy. And I couldn't think of a better person to see my little sister with. I love you both. I wish you all happiness in the world.
My mother made a little bet before the wedding started. She said, well, first of all, they gave me a 20% chance of not trying at the wedding. So she bet anybody in my family that didn't try at the wedding that they would get $50. So I just wanted to let my mother
know. I lost first.
I just wanted to let my mother know that you owe me $50. And I think it should be 100 because I sang the song.
It'll be under your pillow when you come spend the night.
Okay, now. Yes.
The other one asked, where are they? Oh my God, she got the pen touching. You are.
Yeah.
That's what they look like in church of God. What's the
house bonfire?
I'm gonna sit down, honey, now, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thanks.
As much as I love Jamie, I don't love this. I know. So, all right. So you have 10 seconds to turn around. Well, I got more money. There is no time left. Don't even try. Okay. For $15 more, I'll let them take a picture of it. No. Oh, no. One last thing, Andrew. When you're done with that, there was a $10 donation to wash the wind from the floor. After.
Thank you.
Jenny Esker with Goofy Carl. Sarah Esker by Grimsby Dan. The Maid of Honor, Sue Esker by the best man, Jamie. For the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Andy and Laura Smith. Their first song is The Luckiest by Ben Goldstein.
Maybe I'd be outside.
Elvis Presley can't help falling in love. Can I please have a wedding party join in? Thank you very much. Wedding party, come on in.
Don't be shy.
Don't go too far, please.
Thank you.
career on the way up. Generation Classic this year. And you just step in the back of your bride and cover her eyes. You may spin around and around, but be careful. Whatever you do to her bride, she gets to name you next. Somebody's gonna start the song. We'll see. He's a lovely baby tonight. Mike? I'm sorry, we're gonna practice one. Ladies, I want you to move to your right, and when I stop the song, Laura, you may throw it back. We'll see if she gets it twice. Ladies, let's go.
Hold on. we're into this little boat. Who wants to see him take it off his hands? Anybody here? Oh, Andy? Who's gonna want to take it off his teeth? Oh yeah. Have you practiced? We'll see how long it takes you. Anybody got a roadmap? Oh, you didn't need one. Oh, yeah. Oh. Okay, Mike, I think he was down in our history books as fastest. Didn't even get him. Start the song. All right. Good job. Very good job. Okay, gentlemen, if you are bachelors, stay out here. Bachelors, come on out. Come on, bachelors. Bring on, bachelors. And you can come in here. There's going to be a shy as well.
You're so tall, we need to stretch down a little bit. No, this is the fun part of the night, Laura. You're going to get him as easy as possible if you want, because after this, we're done. So sometimes Brian's last laugh. Gentlemen, we're going to start this song. Move to your left, start your stuff, and see who gets the guard for the night.
Thank you.
Leslie, Andy, and Sandy, of course. This next song is a very popular one. What a wonderful movie. Congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Where's the lady who caught them? Okay.
And the gentleman go to the bank and get another.
Did you guys say you were getting away with all the dance? I am the lady. After this song, who are you just dancing young? Now in tradition, this is supposed to be our next round of couple. We'll see where it goes. Who knows? It's a tradition thing. Congratulations guys for catching the driver bouquet. Here's your song. Ladies and gentlemen, I do ask that after a few moments you do join in. Thank you. Thank you guys very much. I have a good next song. This song is called The Wedding Song. And I was told this is your song, and you guys got married. Congratulations. Anthony and Laura, where are you guys at? Familiar with joining me on this song. I want to wish you guys many years of happiness. Here's your song.
Thank you.